Today I am going to discuss DC motor. DC means direct current. DC motor. What is a DC motor? It converts electrical energy to mechanical energy. If you pass the current, it does the work. That means electrical energy converted to mechanical energy. What is DC motor? If they ask for 1 mark, you have to tell. DC motor is the one which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. You must know that one. And what is the principle? Working principle. Working principle. That is Fleming's left hand rule. Fleming's left hand rule. Magnetic, this is the direction of the magnetic field. This is the direction of the current. This is the force. Okay. So example, here it consists of, look, the animated picture is shown here. It is very clear. It consists of a rectangular ABCD. Rectangular coil. This is insulated copper wire, right? This is insulated copper wire. This is called armature, right? It consists of rectangle ABCD of copper wire. The coil is placed between two poles of a permanent magnet, south and north. South and north. Is it clear? Permanent magnet such that the arm AB, this is AB and CD, are perpendicular to the direction of the magnetic field. Direction of the magnetic field is going from here. See, north to south. Right? In your textbook, here north is there, south is there, whatever it is. This armature. This AB, AB, CD, perpendicular to the magnetic field. Now the ends of the coil, this is the ends of the coil, are connected to two half. Here one half, another half. Right? Connected two halves. This is called a P and Q. I am going to write it. P and Q of split ring. One ring is splitted into two parts. This is one ring. This is another ring. Split ring. There is a small gap in between that. Split ring. This split ring is also called commutator segment. We call it commutator segment. And inner side is what? The inner side is completely insulated. Normally there will be keep one axis. Axle. It is connected to an axle. Right? Attached to the axle. Outside. So that when it rotates outside, it rotates like a fan or whatever the work you can get it from that. Okay. This is an axle. And there are two brushes. Right? Outside is conducting. Inside is what? Insulated. Outside is the inner side of P and Q are insulated. Attached to an axle. The external edges. This is P and Q. The external edges. Touch the conducting. This is the conducting. Stationary brushes. This is X and Y. X and Y. Okay. Now what? Connected to a battery, positive and negative. See, often you have to go through whatever I teach or teacher teaches, whoever it is. Just go through the animated picture or YouTube. And what we do it only 10%. And you learn through discussions and YouTube. You'll be getting 90% of the knowledge. Even missing point, you'll learn all that. Okay. Now, this how I'm going to write it. See, it consists of, first, it consists of a rectangular coil A, B, C, D, C. In the examination, you can't write that three dimension diagram. A, B, C, D. Now, this is connected to two split ring, here one, split ring. Okay, split ring. This is axle, right? Axle. This is AX, axle, it's connected to axle. This is split ring. This is, you can write split ring, or you call commutator segment commutator instrument, and you have two carbon brushes. Here one brush, here one brush. This is X and Y. Right? This side is what? North pole. This is South pole. Therefore, DC motor consists of a rectangular coil A, B, C, D of what? Insulated. That is what? First point is what? Rectangular coil A, B, C, D of insulated copper wire. This is the first point. They are placed between two poles of permanent magnet. That is poles, that is north and south, permanent magnet. Such that the arm AB and CD are perpendicular to the magnetic field B. See, the magnetic field start from north to south. Okay. This perpendicular, right? This is the magnetic field. See, this B is different from this. This is a representation of magnetic field. The magnetic field is perpendicular to the line. Okay. Magnetic field. Got it? The ends of the coil, this is the ends of the coil, are connected to the two half P and Q. This is what? P and Q. P and Q of split ring or commutator segment. This inner side of PQ are insulated and attached to what? Attached to an axle. It's an attached to an axle. It is fixed here. This ring fixed to this axle. This also fixed to an axle. There are two brushes. And there is an external. This external is conducting. Inside is insulated. The external conducting edges of P and Q are touch, are two connecting station. What is connect? Touch two brushes. These are called stationary brushes, X and Y. Got it? Then the current, how here you have to write the battery also. See, from here, wire comes out and connected to a battery, positive, positive, negative, like this. And here also, a plug key. If you want a rheostat, you can use it. Rheostat, it increases the current, strength of the current. Current goes like this, right? It goes like this. See how it is. Now, what will happen? See, working. This is the description you have done. What is the description? It consists of a rectangular coil A, B, C, D of insulated copper wire. Insulated, don't write insulated, insulated copper wire placed between two permanent magnet, permanent poles of two permanent magnets, such that the arm AB and CD are perpendicular to the direction of the magnetic field. Ends of the coil are connected to the two half, that is important, two half of split ring, that is P and Q, right? Inner side is insulated and fixed to the axle, and outer conducting split ring is attached to the touched by two brushes X and Y, and X and Y are connected to a battery, right? A plug key and rheostat and so on. Now, what is the working here? Working is this: the current enters the current entering. This is the direction of the magnetic field. Now see, current is entering. Look. See, this is the Fleming's left hand rule, right? Current, this is the direction of the magnetic field, this is the direction of the current. But current is entering this direction. No? Now you have to write like this, reverse. You understood? See how I done. Current entering, magnetic field, force is downward. Force is downward. How to represent the downward force? See, it is inside side. The force is downward. Therefore, here, this is the direction of the current. This direction of the magnetic field. This conductor, that is AB, experience of force downward inside the paper. Inside the paper. Therefore, force, see, I'll write it AB. See, this is AB, right? This is the direction of the current. The force is downwards. You understood? AB, CD. Now the current goes here and coming like this. See, this is the north pole and the south pole. Right? Current going like this. Current here. But see, because this is the direction of the field, current also in the same direction, it will not experience, BC will not experience any force. This is the force downwards. They are mutually perpendicular. Current and magnetic field are mutually perpendicular. Force is also perpendicular downward. Now what happens? This time what will happen? Look here, see. Now the current flows here. Here it will not experience any force. Now again current coming down. Magnetic field is there. Force is upward. Force is upward. The force, I'll write it like this. Force is upward. The force is what? Upward. The force. Can you see this one? You have to imagine. Therefore, here one upward force and downward force. What will happen? Here see. C and D. Current is entering like this. Current is entering. Magnetic field is this direction. Force is upward. Upward. See, upward is denoted by one dot. Coming up inside the paper, denoted by down inside. Equal and opposite force, it started rotating. It rotate. Can you follow? There, as a result, what happens? This is stationary. This is stationary. Brushes are stationary. Now what happens when it rotates? What will happen? Because two equal and opposite force. One force is upward, another force is downwards. As a result, the coil or this coil rotates. What will happen? After one rotation, the C comes here, B goes there. Right? In other words, D comes here, A goes there. Got it? But in spite of that, current goes in one side, the same direction. Current goes in the same direction. Therefore, I'll describe you again. The current enters the coil from the, what is it, battery. It's called source battery. Through how it is entering? Through the brushes. It's called through the brushes and flows back, goes along with this direction A, B, C, D, and again come back, go to the Q, Y, and come back to the battery itself. Therefore, the current enters the coil from the battery through X and flow back to battery through Y. That means it is going like this and coming back. When the current flows to the arm AB, the force on the conductor, what? The force on the conductor, downwards. This is downwards. Downward is into, that is inside the paper. According to the what rule? Fleming's left hand rule. This is Fleming's left hand rule. Again, I'll tell you, the current, see, current is flowing like this. Magnetic field is this direction, force is downward. And again here, the direction of the current and direction of the magnetic field, see, direction of the current and direction of the magnetic field, same or same direction, they are not perpendicular, therefore there is no force. Then again what? Conductor, current, magnetic field is this direction, current is flowing like this, force will be upward, therefore two equal and opposite force, this is upward, upward. Again what? Fleming's left hand rule. Again I am doing it. Two equal and opposite forces rotates. When it rotates, the split ring rotates. This also because attached to this axis. Given the axis rotate, but the brush remains stationary. Right? The brush remains stationary. That means this here in this case, what happens? Down and up there. The armature. This is called what you can call? Armature. Armature rotate what direction? Anti-clockwise direction. Anti-clockwise direction. Anti-clockwise direction. Now, so that the current rotates the coil in the anti-clockwise direction. This will continue. This is the working of the, this is the working of the DC motor. See how they allot the mark. This is one mark. Diagram one mark only. But you have to be very, very careful with this. This, all these things, one mark. But some textbook, sometimes the question paper, they'll ask, two mark, they'll ask you. Draw the diagram. What is armature? What is armature, they'll ask you. And what is commutator ring? Where is axle, brushes? And all these things, split ring, everything, they'll ask you to do that for 2 marks. The working, description, 2 mark they may ask. Working, 2 mark they'll ask. Therefore, sometime, fully 4 marks also they may ask. Therefore, this is for 4 mark question, they'll ask you. Right? And apart from this, you go through YouTube, how to draw the diagram, analyze, and go and visit your lab, college, school lab, and working model and all, just go through, right? Other, unless otherwise, but the real motor and the real model, it's very complicated because you are only 2 magnets. A lot of magnets are there, right? In the splitted part, so that it will be more powerful. And use, open it and see the real motor, the real design. That is very interesting, it's complicated, but interesting, right? Okay.